Hello friends, myself Professor Shantay Gurmat, Department of Botany, MGVC Arts, Commerce and Science College, Mudeh Bihar, Karnataka State. Friends, today's class we discuss about morphology of angiosperms. The first one is root system. When the seed is germinated, it produces two parts, one is a radical and another one is plumule. The radical is always produced in the root system, and this is the descending part of the plant body, and the plumule is always produced in the stem or shoot system. It always positively phototropic. Root in the botany, that part of a vascular plant normally underground, its primary functions are anchorage of the plant, absorption of water and dissolved minerals and conduction of these to the stem, and storage of reserve foods. The root differs from the stem mainly by lacking leaf scars and buds, having a root cap and having branches that originate from the internal tissue rather than from buds. The root system of a plant constantly provides the stems and leaves with water and dissolved minerals, characterized by having one main root, that is a tap root, from which smaller root emerges. When a seed germinates, the first root to emerge is the radical or primary root. Then modification of roots. First one is taproot modified for storage of food. Number one, fusiform root. When the root is swollen in the middle and generally tapering towards the apex and the base, being more or less spindle shaped. In appearance, it is said to be fusiform. The best example is radish. Second one is conical root. When the root is broad at the base and gradually tapers towards the apex like cone, it is said to be conical. Example is carrot. Third one is nepiform root. When the root is considerably swollen at the upper part, becoming almost spherical and sharply tapering at the lower part, it is said to be nepiform. The examples are turnip and beetroot. Then tuberous root. When the root is thick and fleshy but does not take a definite shape, it is said to be tuberous. Examples are Mirabilis jalapa, or commonly known as 4 o'clock plant. Then branched roots. The first one is nematophores. Many plants growing in marshy places and salt lakes, occasionally inundated by tides as in the Sundarbans, develop a special kinds of roots called respiratory roots or nematophores. For the purpose of respiration, such roots grow from the underground roots of the plant but rise vertically upwards and come out of the water like so many conical spikes or horn-like structures. They often occurs in large numbers around the tree upper end, with numerous pores or respiratory spaces through which air is taken in for respiration. The example is rhizophora. Then adventitious roots modified for storage of food. Number one, fasciculated roots. When several tubercular roots occur in a cluster or fasciculate at the base of the stem, they are said to be fasciculated. Example is dahlia. Second one is nodulose roots. When the slender roots become suddenly swollen at the apex, it is said to be nodulose, as in mango, ginger, turmeric and asparagus. And moniliform or beaded roots. When there are some swellings in the roots at frequent intervals, it is said to be moniliform or beaded. Best example is momordica. And fourth one is annulated roots. When the root has a series of ring-like swellings on its body, it is said to be annihilated. Best example is APEC. Then for mechanical support, number one, prop roots. In plants like banyan, Indian rubber plant, a number of roots are produced from the main stem and often from the branches. These roots grow vertically downward and penetrates into the soil. Gradually they get stouter and act as a pillars supporting the main stem and the branches or the plants as a whole. Such roots are known as prop roots. The big banyan tree in India, Indian Botanical Garden near Kolkata, has produced over 900 such roots from its branches. Its age is about 200 years and the circumference of a crown is well over 360 meters. Second one is climbing roots. Plants like betel produce climbing roots from their nodes and often from the internodes to ensure a foothold on neighboring objects. The best example is betel and pothos. The third one is sucking roots. Parasites develop roots which penetrates into the tissue of the host plant and suck it. Such roots are known as sucking roots. Best example is Hostoria. Best example is Cuscuta. Next one is epiphytic roots. These are certain plants, commonly orchids, which grow perched branches of trees. Such plants are known as epiphytes. They never suck the supporting plants as do the parasites. So instead of sucking roots, they develop a special kind of roots which hang freely in the air. Each hanging roots is surrounded by a spongy tissue called velamen tissue. With the help of this velamen, the hanging roots absorb moisture from the surrounding air. The best example is Vanda. Okay, thank you friends. So we meet in the next video.